Why, hello. Let's hope this works. As I just realized, might not have fixed my microphone. It should be correct. Everything sounds like it should, right? Also, hello. How are you people doing today? Pudding is easier. I have no idea. Also, we have girl power in chat today. I approve. So, as you can tell by the title, which is somewhere on the screen, we're going to be continuing on the blocks today. And hopefully finish the character sheet. Or so I hope, anyway. So let's hop on over to there. This is a well done, Will. Speaking of which, you people are insane. Well, I guess you can't see it right now, because the whole code thing isn't. But up in the corner there, all the way over there, it says 41. What is wrong with you? I mean, it's awesome, but Jesus. I appreciate the support. It's like, holy crap! So many likes and comments. You are insane. Appreciate you people. You are amazing. Eric the cheats. Yeah, we're working on it. So this is what it looks like right now. And it looks fine here. If this was what it looked like when you put it in an article, I would be happy with it. Because this looks fine. This, I mean, the colors are completely all over the place, but that's just because I need it. Ew, that's not. Hold up. No. That should be the one.
No.
Actually, I think I might know what that is. I think it's Zoom that has been messing with my audio settings. It's not coming from either left or right, right? It should be a mono signal. Weird? It's mono. Okay, good. No? This isn't right. There, now the music is back. Okay, good. That didn't change anything, did it? Or did it? I'm not sure. How is the sound now? I don't think it's going to be any better, because I didn't actually change anything. At least I don't think so. Oh, there we go. That's got to be there. And... how's the audio? Am I peaking a lot? I mean, if I talk very loudly, it looks like I'm peaking like mad. So if I do that, is that better? Or do I simply just peak still, but I can't see it? The trouble is, I can't check this while I'm streaming, which is really annoying. Crashes are the worst. And now chat is super quiet, which is also not great. getting better, but some peak, but clearer sound. Okay. Now if we just turn this down a little bit. Put the limiter to there. Kill the compressor. Figured I'd let the sound experts type. Well, she's got sensitive ears. I think I'm just gonna leave it without a gain and see if that works. The clearer sound is probably because I'm closer to the microphone. I'm gonna leave it at that. We'll see if it works. If not, yell at me. Anyway. Cheat. If it looked like this, I would be happy with it. But it doesn't. If you put it in an article, it looks like this. Completely white. No. But it looks like... Wait, hold on. Yeah, okay, first off, it puts the skill and the value on different rows, which is not what I want. Why does it do that? Oh yeah, it's glowy. That's just a feature of my CSS. I should probably fix that. Does that help? That does not help. Okay. Why not? Oh, wait. Oh. Will that help or will that break everything wrong? I'm just trying to make things spaced correctly right now. No, I didn't think so. That's not where you put that. So let's remove this. The thing that is messing with me right now is that I can make it work by doing this. MD6. Is boss music? Yeah, it is. So this might be a little bit hectic. The reason we don't have the standard music right now is because one of my hard drives in my file server decided to die. Which means all my music is gone. So I had to quickly download some free music from Bandcamp and just throw it into my music player so we can have something to listen to. Because hard drive crashes are fun. Also, can we put this over here instead? There. Because I'm looking at the screen over there. Oh. So it worked for the traits, but the skills are still messed up as balls. And if I take away the margins here, that'll solve everything. Still not the one. Okay, just close that one. So, this solves it. Right? Okay, I should look at this. See, if I do not have a margin in between these, it works. And it should also work here. Yes. See, now the skills are on one row, right? What I want is to have a fine margin in between here without pushing it to the next row. And I can't figure out how to do that. Which is really obnoxious because I want a slight gap in between here. Ideally, I'd want this to be like here. So, say, I would like to have it be 9 and 3. Yes, those are the correct numbers. If I do this, I would like to have it like this. Beep. And have a small margin. But if I add a margin, it just jumps to the next line. And I don't understand why it's really obnoxious. If I do like margin left 1 and put that in and load the sheet again, nothing happened. Okay. That is supposed to work. What the hell? margin right. Necrodancer, best soundtrack. Yeah, there we go. It just throws it to the next row. 30% width. I guess you. I think you can do that in Bootstrap, right? Bootstrap percent width. Oh boy. Ah. I guess we can try that. How does that work with columns, though? The tracks with the shopkeeper are the best. I don't disagree. He's awesome. So width. What was the command? Wh. So what? 75. Margin. Right one. Yeah. And then this. With 25 and no margin. Whoops. Do not hit the microphone. We'll try that. I don't think this is gonna help, but we try. That. You logged in right as I was singing. That's a good one to join on. I mean, that looks okay, but what the fuck? Still puts them on different rows, though. Okay, we're getting closer. Your timing was glorious.
Yes. It does sound like your timing was indeed glorious.
Okay, fine. Fine. We will try this. Where are you at on the sheet? It's pretty much done. I'm just wrestling with making it look all right.
I do not understand this.
See, the problem is here. It throws them on different rows. It's supposed to be intimidation, skill value, handguns, skill value, not intimidation, skill value. You can't set the right column width? Tried. They're both on 25 right now, and that did nothing. It works here, but I don't think the width applies to column classes, to be honest. If I take them away, I think it's going to do absolutely nothing. I'm pretty sure it's the same thing without that. Yeah. Oh, it's in Wii Out. Well, I'm out. Yeah, it is. It was. I was working on the printable sheet before, which is the which was in Scribus, is the name of the app. But that was the printable PDF. This is the World Anvil sheet. Doom music. Okay, so
I'm going to need to make a card box for everything, which is going to be a little bit difficult.
Or maybe not, actually.
Hoo-hum.
It's gonna be here. Yeah. And then two closing divs at the end. Da 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 div. Pulling up my sheep to see what I did. I did that, Nina. I did left 75, right 25, and that did nothing. It looked exactly like this. So I don't think that the width class applies to the column class for some reason. I wouldn't know why, but it doesn't. Oh my fuck, that needs padding. That looks awful. What? What even happened? That looks wrong. There are too many rows and columns here. Remove. I don't want to break anything. Then you have an overruling class somewhere. Yeah, probably inside Bootstrap itself. This became weird. I think what we're gonna do is this. And we will just turn this column into card box instead. Which did nothing. That is intriguing, but it doesn't really need a box though. Now that I think about it, actually. This does, but I don't think anything else really needs a box. Because they have boxes already. Because I did this with 75. No, not that one. Not that class. Here, this is what manages the skills column. So if I do width 75 and the other with 25 and go into here and paste it, save and load the sheet, absolutely no difference. So somewhere this gets overridden. It even says with 75% important, and it still ignores it. Oh, I forgot to add the code again. Whoops. There we go. I don't know why it does that. Oh well, it's not really that important. What I needed to do is to stop putting them on different rows. That is the important part. The rest I can fix later. To be honest, the sheet kind of works if you look at it here, which is all I ever wanted. So what I'm actually gonna do is just make it usable. Did you PN me on Discord? Yeah. Yeah, MD4 means you have like three. That's basically what I'm doing too. Because no, according to Bootstrap, it's W-75, but that's the width class for Bootstrap. And it just doesn't do anything. It adds it. It says the width is supposed to be there, but it doesn't actually do anything for some reason. Anyway, I did that actually. I have, if you look here, these three are coal MD4s. So it's one MD4, one MD4, one MD4. And then inside that each MD4, there are two, right now, equal width columns. So this is one column, this is one MD4, and inside there's two coal MDs. And what I would like to happen is for this one to be like to here and still have a margin. And that's what I can't make work. Because it's easy to make it have that width. Like if I remove the margin and just make this 9 width, and then I make this 3 width. The music too loud. It's too loud for me. And then just put it in here. And I'll show you what I mean. That looks correct, right? Now the middle moved over to the right, which is fine. But if I now add a margin, so margin right one, and save, for some reason, instead of making each column a little bit smaller, it just puts it on the next row, which is incredibly frustrating. I don't know why it does that. It's really obnoxious. I don't think it's a ticket. I think it's me not understanding how Bootstrap works. So I don't think it's a bug or anything. It's just I don't understand how Bootstrap works. Anyway, for right now, it's more important that they look okay. So we'll put it in without that gap in between. If I put it as an absolute, it will break depending on what people have screen resolution for. I want to have them dynamic as much as I can because I don't want to break it for people with different sized screens than I have. For instance, if someone has like this, it would absolutely break everything. But as you can see, it still works now. But whatever. I'm actually relatively happy with how this looks. So what I'm going to do is take the colors out, because we don't actually need the colors. So people can use this, and then I'll work on making it pretty later, because I really need to start working on the item sheet as well. I'm going to take out all of the colors. Actually, I'm not going to take out all the colors without backing that up first. Then I'm going to take out all the colors. That's 7525. Yeah. I think the color is just gonna default to black, right? We do this? At least I hope so. This song was really annoying. Can we get the next one, please? I wasn't a fan of that one. Whoops. The worst part of listening to Necrodancer music is that it makes you want to play Necrodancer. That is the worst part of it. There we go. Now it should be in white. Oh, right, I forgot the dots. There we go. You gotta set it to less than 75 and 25 if you wanna add margin, because margin adds to the total and that puts you above 100%. Yeah. That's my understanding as well. But the thing is, if I add width, It doesn't care. That's my problem. So with, say, 70 and with 20, now there's 10 pixels and I add a margin right one here, for instance. It doesn't seem to care about width. As you can see, it adds the margin, but it doesn't give a fuck about the width value. In spite, by the way, of applying a width value somewhere. It was there a second ago. Where the hell did it go? There, with, no, width 100%. What? Why you not add the width right now? What did I do? I am now confused. Oh, right. It only supports... if I read correctly in Bootstrap, it only supports 25, 50, 75, and 100. You can't have, like, 70. If I do 75 and 25, it should work. But that doesn't fix my problem. Yeah, now the width is there. But it, as you can see, it doesn't even care. It's still 50-50. For some bloody reason, I don't know why. But I don't care anymore. I have given up. I'll do this. Because it works. I can fix it later. I need to move on to other blocks. There. There is now a character sheet. It's all just to mess with my mind. Indeed it is. Alright, I'm gonna message Dimmy and have him throw this into live. If this works, does it? It does kinda. This isn't really pretty. And I think that's because this margin is too large. I'm just gonna fix that margin a little bit. And that part is under injuries, which is where? Here. It has way too large of a margin between the names and the dots. Why? Hold up. Four? Oh, margin one. Ooh, it should only be margin right one. Right? Also, this shouldn't have a margin at all. Yeah, it should, actually. Ugh. I have to do the thing. This needs a margin right one and a margin bottom one. That's what it needs. And then the dots should have a margin bottom one. That's all. Otherwise, everything gets really wrong. So, stress margin right one, margin bottom one. No, we already have a margin on the row, so it doesn't have to have a margin bottom. I think. I'm just theorizing here, and again, I'm not actually really good with understanding how the fuck this doesn't need a margin, how Bootstrap actually treats margins and stuff. That doesn't need a margin. Good thing is that it's easy to fix if it turns out that I'm wrong. I'll just undo all of this. There we go. That changed fuck all for some reason. What? Why is there such a huge margin in between here? Okay, so I'm making a new row. A new column and a new row and a new column. I am confused. There shouldn't be such a huge gap here. This gap should really only be like the gap that was between this before. But it's not. Either way, not really a problem. Though my problem is that it's fuckmongous here. I'm not sure why. Have I changed anything in my CSS here? When it comes to stat blocks. Stat block. No. Haven't. I haven't really done anything but add the border around. I haven't even messed with margins or anything. The font size, though, if you take that away, what happens then? It gets even worse. Okay, that's awesome. Whoops. It's so weird that, like, this margin here just disappears in the live thing. But that should be pretty easy. That is the margin between this column and the other one. Why is it here when I haven't added a margin? You know this confuses me greatly. What if you close this? Okay, so if I add a margin right here, I am 100% sure that this is going to explode in a fantastic fashion. Yep, it did. Except for here. What?
My head hurts.
You know what? Fuck it. I'm gonna steal Adamal someday and do this. We have fiddled with this enough. It works here, which is where I want people to use it. That's enough. I'll fix it later. For now. Where is Dimmy in my... There is Dimmy. New block for you. No. That's not it. I'm an idiot. There we go. Okay. Oh god. Let's go to stats and shit blocks. Let's say. Okay, we can remove that now. Don't be so hard on yourself. That's our job. Yeah, sure. Well, I will fix it later. I just need it out there. Adamol is really good at CSS, so I can steal his face for that. All right, now time for a new one. We're gonna save this as VA item sheet main. I actually saved it as a wrong. I should save it again. Save as we I am added at that. There we go. And now we need to remove the wrong one. And it's also gonna be in there. Don't save. Open file. That one. Language HTML twig. Toilet paper. Oh boy, this is gonna break everything, isn't it? It's definitely gonna break everything. So I think what I'm gonna do is keep the old item template, and instead of changing it, I'm just gonna add new ones, right? That seems like a way smarter idea than breaking what's already there. Yeah, let's do that. So create a new. Let's start. The D&D ones are modular that way, I think. The thing is, my sheet is modular in the sense that it just adapts to whatever the item is that you put in. But it's a pain in the butt to maintain. Like, if I look at a small sword, for instance, this, oh, it's a little bit broken, but this is what it looks like, right? If I remove the code window, this is kind of what it looks like. But there's an information box at the top, and the things up here vary with what type of weapon you've chosen. In this case, I've chosen a melee weapon, right? So it lists the information required, and then it lists the stats required and adds a description at the bottom. That's fine. But it gets really, 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 really awkward, because this one supports like weapons, armor, ammunition, everything. And it's a nightmare to maintain. Let me show you a ranged weapon. Like a compound bow, for instance. Seems fine, right? Now let me show you the code for this.
It is a nightmare.
Item template. And go to display mode. I'm just gonna throw it into Adam, because otherwise you won't see anything. Code. So here's the code. Let's start from the top. Almost 400 lines of code. just to show an item. And that's not the only problem. Because if we look at the compound bow again, and we look at what it looks like for the user to enter everything, we got this. That is way too many boxes to fill out for a pouch, for instance. You don't need all this crap to make a pouch. You don't need magazine to make a bow or a sword. You do not need, I don't know, reach for a bow. There's a lot of things here that are just unnecessary, and it makes it hard on the user, and it makes it hard for me to maintain the code. So what I'm gonna do is gonna break it out into like basic item, ranged weapon, melee weapon, armor, etc. So I can have very simple blocks instead of having a gigantic block of text for someone to enter. So that's my idea. All right, I'm gonna read up on chat because I just noticed a lot of stuff happened that I missed. I just threw CD10 and CD10 DS at one of my players, and he was like, so this hardcore 5e guy left my party, and there's this system that I think looks neat, but my game is power fantasy in some way, but this system seems interesting. What do you think? And now he's like, well, the fantasy module is low magic, and it's not power fantasy game as your game has been, but it looks really nice. And now he's mildly hype about it. Well, that's good. Whoops. Someone posted a link. Don't post links. At least not without asking first or being a subscriber. But that's nice. What's code? Oh, it's just... Yeah. Throw the code at me on Discord instead. Because code in... It for some reason thinks it's links when it's stuff in it. I don't know why. Yeah, that's just a basic if statement. And those are fine. The thing is, this thing adapts its entire structure depending on what kind of item it is, which is nuts. And I'm gonna break it. And also make it prettier, because right now I'm not, words are hard. Because I'm not actually happy with what it looks like either. Because it's oogly, and it can be prettier. Because look at this. It's just not very pretty. I can make this prettier, in my opinion. This music is so hype. The problem is... is really hyped up and is like, oh my god, you mean that two characters he plays in two different campaigns could be mechanically different? Hype! Yes, definitely. Okay, so CD10, basic item. A sheet for adding basic items that have no significant stats to the game. I guess I could start from my own, just duplicating it, but yeah, actually I could do that. So destroy this. Let's go to item. Item template, edit, duplicate. Now we are in duplicate mode. But can I change the name of it? I don't think I can. Or can I? I have a hardcore Shadowrun friend that I want to send a link about CD10. What is the best page on your site site for them to read to get an overview and understanding of mechanics. That depends on if you want to send them like the rule system or the world COTC. Because if it's the rule system, then why don't I have that here? Are you kidding me? There it is. What? Like, whatever. Rule system is here. I think. Yes. That is the starting point for it. Yeah, it is an item template. Can I rename this? It doesn't actually look like I can. No. That's a pain in the ass. Why can't I change the name of the template? Or am I just stupid? I want to change this. I hear an echo. Is that just me? I don't know. Maybe you hear an echo, because everything is broken right now. No, I can't change the name of it. That is real bad. Okay, fine. Okay, whatever. Let's not do that then. New item template. CD10. Basic item. A cheat for adding basic template. That. Okay, what do we need in it? Hello? What just happened? Thank you. I don't know. If you hear an echo. Hopefully you don't. Hopefully it's just all in your imagination. Okay, so here is the type selector. Like you select from a type list. So if variables, armor type, blah 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 blah, it checks which of these sections it's going to display, which is messy as balls. If variables type armor, for instance, then show this. If it's ranged weapon, show this, etc, etc. It's just no, please pop, it hurts my head. I don't want it like this.
I do not want it like this. It is a messy, messy way to do things.
So what I'm thinking here is to have an info box at the top. No, wait. What is to stop me from just making it like an info box on the left and a description on the right? So you have like a box of stats, and then you have a description on the right. That would only take like two columns. Sure, why not? So what do we need? We need... How do I do this simplest? I don't know what I look at though. I need items. Oh, item template. It's gonna be a basic item. Do I have any basic items added? I have so much crap. This is gonna take forever to convert. this. Yeah, that, yeah. What's this? Just empty. Yeah, that is just empty. Weird. Reanimate! Exactly!
Reanimate!
Scroll. So there was an empty one down here. We're probably just gonna remove. There are so many empty ones. Delete. Yeah. Oh my god. Why does it reload the list after I do that? That's obnoxious.
Reanimate.
There we go. Be gone. Fine, I'll go through the code. I didn't want to, but let's go through the code. What do I need? I guess we need a type. Which is a string. What kind of item is it? So, a pouch. Torch. Right, my light source. What else? Clothing. Boom. What else? Info box. Availability? Skill required. Skill required should probably be there. If it is like an electronics kit or something. You know? No. The item doesn't require I don't know. Maybe. Well, we'll add them anyway. So availability. Obviously. Skill required. Whoops. I am bad. Skill required. Ammunition is not necessary because that's going to be on weapon. Trader, where can you buy it? Price, what does it cost? Trade group, that is if you're playing in CD10DS, then things don't have a price, it has a trade group. Quality. Weight could be interesting, I suppose. Protected areas and defensive value. This is only necessary for weapons. But that's it. Now all we need is a description. Awesome. I need supper too, but we're not there yet. So next up we have availability.
Availability!
This is a list for a selection, actually. Very... The first is common. Then we have... No. Okay, common. Then we have very rare. Rare. Common. Very common. Actually, I think those are based on the DS list, right? So we could probably check the DS rules.
You?
And see what the article says. Blah, 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 blah. Trading groups, quality, supply and demand. Back to work. Have a good one. Good luck. Yeah, quality. Supply and demand is plus minus 2, which means we do need 4. So we're gonna have very rare, rare, common, or normal, then common, very common. Yeah, I guess so. So normal. Common. Very common. Oh, that works. And then we should have trader. Where can the item be bought? Farmer. Tavern. Cybernetics. Clinic. Weapons dealer, etc. We should fix this. And so, how common is the item? More common items are usually cheaper. Trader price. Integer. No, actually, let's just make that a string. What does the item cost? If you are using trade groups from the advanced trade module, use trade group instead. 5,000. What? My numlock is off. Why? 5,000 credits. Add templates. And then we have trade group. If you are using advanced trade, the advanced trade module for medieval settings, this is the items. Trade group. G2, G4, G9. And then we have quality. And this is a selection as well. Normal. And shoddy, poor, high, superb. Shoddy, poor, high, superb. What is the quality of the item? Wait. What does the item weigh? 2 kilos, 3 kilos, 4 or 5 pounds. 19 nugadugas. Description. Long text. A text description of the item. And I should steal this from somewhere, I think. Because I should. It's music, bro. There we go. Now we need to switch to display mode and get our boilerplate in place. Do we need a boilerplate? Yeah, we should probably have a boilerplate. Save. And then make a new one. Oh yeah. Very rare. Trader, Ogre shop. Price. Priceless! Quality. Superb. Weight. Too much. Ogre dogas are awesome. I just need something to be able to look at. There we go. Done. I'm out. Okay, never mind. I'm not. But even if I'm not out, we're gonna have to stop there.
Because it is time to switch to the next scene.
My player just asked, how many traits do you have in CD10? That's a question that could be answered two ways. It's either how many traits are available in CD10, or how many traits can you as a character have? And those are pretty different. There is a lot of traits, yes. But each character only has about 10 to 12 traits, maybe. But yeah, there's a lot available in the... I mean, in the core, there's just a few available. But if you have the advanced traits module, you have a lot and you can make your own. So, as someone said, as Nina said, infinite. You want to come up with a trait? Sure, do it. So a lot. But there is a guide for how to create traits. You can take a look at that, actually. So if we look here, creating your own traits. Since traits are so flexible, the list below is only an inspirational source of traits. They're there to provide you with something to get your creativity flowing, to come up with unique and fun traits for your character to have. To create new traits is one of the strengths of the CD10 system, and you are encouraged to come up with your own. There are, however, a few things you should keep in mind when doing so. Take a look at this list, for instance. 1. Traits should be easy to understand. It shouldn't need pages upon pages of explanation if you can avoid it. Ideally, they should be self-explanatory through their title alone, such as Agile or Friendly. If your custom traits need more than a few sentences of explanation, you may want to rethink the trait and make it smaller and more focused. At most, a trait should have a sentence or two of explanation and perhaps a sentence per level, but that's it. Traits should be balanced. This goes without saying. Traits are not there to make your character broken or overpowered beyond measure. Traits should not be too good, too broad, too bad, or too narrow in scope. They should be just right. The world's best gunner is good in scope, firearms, but its descriptive title isn't good and indicates that you're always better than everyone else. Fantastic gnome whittler is not good as its scope is too narrow. Try to find a good middle ground. And finally, traits should not be skill enhancers. Traits should first and foremost be a narrative choice to flesh out your character and not power gaming min-max boost to a particular skill. Having great handgunner +3 just to boost your shooting is dull and misses the points of traits. Talent for gunnery is better, and it would then reduce the cost of increasing gun-related skills by 1 experience points instead of giving a flat boost to the skill itself. As much as possible, avoid picking a trait that is just a flat bonus to a skill, and instead try to diversify and make more creative traits. If you have a trait that affects a skill, for instance like dark vision, try to make it situational and specific rather than a blanket bonus. That's traits in a nutshell. And again, this is all available on the CD10 world, so just read there. Now! It is the darkest of times. So, to the people on YouTube, I bid you farewell, and I will see you next time.